I could gamble, I'd pay the price. Thought I could handle something undefined. Maybe you'll reach to raise the stakes, cause I can't walk away.
Hey, what is going on, guys? It is your boy Cakeman here, and today I'm bringing you a Gunslinger Guide, which is a subclass to the Hunter within Destiny 2. In this video, I will go over techniques, my build for both the subclass and weapons, reasoning behind my choices, and also an end rating for the character for both PvP and PvE. Before we get into the video itself, let's smash that like button, and I just want to thank you guys for almost 700 subs. I love you guys to death, and let's jump right into this video. Alright guys, so we are starting off with the build right now. And also, let me know if you guys want more of these like little builds or guides to these characters, because I can do them for the Titan, the Warlock, whatever you guys want. Just let me know what you want to see down below, and let's start off with this build for the subclass. So obviously you have your golden gun, your ultimate ability, your super, and it just demolishes, like it says, disintegrates, flaming pistol that disintegrates enemies with solar light. It's really nice. If you guys aren't familiar with it, it fires out 3 shots of solar light that just decimate the enemies. And I know you guys like 3 shots, it actually shoots 6, but that's because of this passive right here, the 6 shooter. So I'm guessing what this little diamond will be is like interchangeable passives, kind of like the old subclass build before in Destiny 1. So it comes with 6 shooter, dead shot, chain of woe, and explosive knife, all of which are really nice. For the PvP aspect of things, I wouldn't go for Chains of Woe, but it still is really nice to have, especially in the PvP version of things. So let's jump into the grenades. We have the incendiary grenade, which does like a lingering damage over time effect, and it has an AoE, of course. The swarm grenade, which kind of just disperses within like a certain radius. I don't know the size exactly, but like it says, a grenade that releases multiple drones that seek nearby enemies. Now the reason I don't really like this grenade is because the seeking isn't that strong, to be honest. Like, it'll follow, but only for a short distance, and if it doesn't touch them, they just go off on their own and really don't do much damage. It's good for holding down like little tunnels, hallways, which you will see in some of the gameplay in the background, but my personal favorite is the trip mine grenade. So it sticks to surfaces and detonates whenever an enemy passes by. It is laser detonated, sorry guys. But it is really nice. It can't stick to enemies like the old one, but if you throw it at them, you might have a good chance of it still exploding. I like to throw it at the wall behind them because it does an insane amount of damage. Next we have our dodge. This is a new thing added to the game. You double tap circle or whatever button it is for you to crouch, and you can do a dodge in any which direction that your left analog stick is pointing, or direction that you're moving in, depending on what platform you play on, I guess. So this one, marksman dodge, whenever you dodge near an enemy, it reloads your weapon, and when it says near, I think that means whenever your radar is kind of like glowing, like heavily glowing, if you guys know what I'm talking about. And then there's the gambler's dodge, what I personally like to run. It recharges your melee ability, and the reason I like to run this is because the melee ability takes forever to recharge, and it is a pain, so I love to run this, especially in PvP. And then we got high jump to jump higher, and then directional jump, or the strafe jump, which kind of lets you like jump forward, jump back if you want. But I don't really like it because I feel like it's not as, like, I don't know how to describe it, but like the jump isn't as powerful in the second time around. And then the triple jump, which I like more because you can kind of cut off the jump in between or go even higher, and you can kind of catch your enemy off guard there. Alright guys, so now you guys kind of got the gist of the build and all that. So now I'm going to talk about the weapons that I run, and it's going to be a little unorthodox, and that is because I run 2 revolvers. I know you guys are thinking like, Cake, what? You run 2 of basically the same gun. Well, basically, the reason I do this is because I like to run a sniper, which I do heavily recommend if you're a pretty good marksman, or even semi-decent, because the sniper in this game is really nice, or at least the one that they've given us so far. Because you can one tap them and then you can switch, and when you switch, it switches to your primary, not your secondary slot. So you'll still whip out a revolver, but if you had like a burst rifle in that place, you would switch to that, and if he's too close to you and you want to get the revolver, you'd have to switch again. So basically you're swapping weapons twice that way, when you could just swap it once and just shoot him down. And I think the revolvers are overall are just a really good choice in the PvP part of the game, which I like to play a lot, and in PvE, especially this one that they've given us, the exotic, the Sunshot, which you see most of this gameplay is with, is very nice to run. And one last thing, the trip mine that I did mention earlier that I said you guys should definitely check out. Whenever you hit them with the trip mine, they are a one shot with any hand cannon so far. I don't know if they're going to release a hand cannon with very low damage or something, but I highly doubt it. So even a body shot hip fire with a trip mine hit is a kill. Another thing that I would like to cover is the throwing knife and how powerful and versatile it can be. You can use it as an AoE weapon, so if there's an enemy hiding around a corner or sprinting towards a corner and you're not even sure if you're going to hit it, throw it at the ground right where they're going or near them, and it can take them out even if they're low, which is a really nice addition to this throwing knife. In Destiny 1 there was a burn effect if you did choose that part of the subclass. But this one I would highly recommend sticking with the explosive knife. And the reason that I say sticking with it, I know you guys in the beta right now are just like, we can't switch anyway, but I'm talking about later in the game, unless they come out with something crazy like 3 throwing knives or something. I don't even know if I would switch with 2, because the explosive is really nice, because even if you stick them in the head for some precision damage, it'll explode right after and do another amazing burst of damage, which is really nice. And it can drop, I would think, about half health. Not entirely sure because they don't have private match out yet. But the throwing knife is definitely a gamble sometimes. Do not heavily rely on it, by no means. But it's kind of like a last resort, or kind of before that. If you're feeling like you're getting pretty confident with these knives, then I would start trying to integrate them more into your gameplay. But I would go for more of a last resort kind of stance with these knives, like I'm saying, if you are new to the hunter. But guys, overall I would say the hunter's gunslinger abilities are a really solid choice to go with, and with a little bit of practice this character is super adaptable and can become a huge burden to the enemy team if you can play him right. So for the PvP side of things, I'm going to give him a 9 just for now. They could tack on some more stuff, they could push it to a 10, but I really don't see much downside to this character other than he's kind of a risk sometimes, especially with his melee ability. And for the PvE side of things, I would probably give him like a 7 just because the melee ability is kind of, it's kind of just situational really. If you want to finish off an enemy, it's alright. And the explosive damage is just because some of the enemies just have too much health to deal with just one throwing knife. If you have something like the Sentinel Melee, which actually kills something and gives you an overshield, that would be insane. But they do that kind of stuff for balancing reasons, of course. So I would give him probably a pretty solid 7, 7.5 if you guys want to go that far into detail. But guys, if you did like this, make sure to drop a like on the video like I said earlier, subscribe if you are brand new, and don't be afraid to comment down below. I do reply to the comments. I won't bite, trust me. But guys, this has been Cake Man, and I will see you guys next time. Peace. You keep taking the upper hand.